Hi again, I'm Diederik, and today we get you started with your GOM Inspect Suite. In this video, I'll be teaching you how to perform 3D inspection in GOM Inspect Suite. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along, and there's also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. Let's get started. What I would like to show you today is 3D inspection on this part. We'll perform some angle inspections and also some distances. To do this, as you can see, I already imported my CAD file and my scan data into GOM Inspect Suite, and I created this pre-alignment. Remember, the global best fit. If you want to make main alignments, also check out the other video regarding main alignments. First thing I want to do is, in this case, I can hide my mesh. And keep in mind, if you do not need your Explorer, just close it and maximize your 3D window. Let's make some planes here in this middle area so we can inspect the angle between them. Construct plane, auto plane, allows me just with one single click to create a plane right here, one on the side, and the other one as well on the side. Great. Using ZEISS Inspect, I can convert these into actual fitting elements, so they're also measured on my real part. Once I have these three planes, I can construct the angle between them. I find angles right here, construct all the way at the bottom, angle, a two-direction angle. Easy click with Control on this plane, and on the second one, gives me here my angle calculation. It should be 95. Let's check what it really is. Same here between plane 4 and plane 6. Converting these into actual angles, and the last step, verifying the actual angle between the planes. Remember, I can enter a tolerance if I like. I'll use 0.2 degree in this case. Confirm, and here I go. Angle 1, nicely within specifications. Angle 2, not so much, just outside. These planes, I can make them invisible using the shortcut I, which I like to use quite a lot. Next to this angle calculation, let's also check a distance. Maybe what is the total width of this part? To calculate this, I'll use a calliper, an outer disc calliper. Why? Because this outer disc calliper, which I find here under Construct, Distance, Outer Disc Calliper, allows me to roughly click a point on one side, select a point on the other side, but now, using the coordinate system here at the bottom, I can see the X direction is the direction of interest, and it directly gives me a preview of these two big calipers. They will close, and the very first points they touch, that's where it measures the distance, exactly what I need. I'll confirm to do this on my complete part. Create and close. This distance 1, I'll convert it into an actual distance and check the X direction. Tolerance is okay like this, and we're good to go. For nicer reporting, I can also drag out this distance and hide the original one. As you can see, I was able to show you how to make these two angle inspections and this outer distance, which I made with the big caliper. Keep in mind, like always, I can store this as a report page with the button up here in the main toolbar, give it an appropriate title, save it as a PDF, and export my PDF results. If you experience anything different from what you've seen here, or if you have any issues with your GOM Inspect Suite, please reach out to us at support@handsonmetrology.com. For more getting started information, check out the other videos as well. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.